The theme for today's talk is continuity and security in today's world. And I now have great pleasure to introduce our moderator for today, Mr. Harry Padmanabhan.
Certain sectors of the economy have been devastated, from travel and hospitality to retail, sports, live entertainment, manufacturing. But across sectors, the segment that seems to have borne the brunt of the pandemic has been the SME segment. But here too, many have been nimble and agile, quickly redefining their service or product or addressing a segment where demand has soared, such as healthcare or the government.
And I think what we've seen in the last 10 weeks, you know, you can compare to what's happened, you know, in the dot-com bubble over a 2-3 year period. It's been condensed. I mean, you've seen,
yes,
it's a very good opportunity for all of us. We've seen something which usually happens over 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. It's been condensed into a 2 month time frame.
I remember in this book, Sun Tzu in The Art of War, he has said that if you know yourself and you know your enemy, then you don't have to worry about the outcome of 100 battles. Now, if you know yourself but you don't know your enemy, then at best you have a 50-50 chance.
20% probably of the applications you use are responsible for 80% of your business. So the first step is to make sure that these applications you can access anywhere, and that your data is accessible from anywhere, and you and the processes you use to manage your company can happen regardless of you being in the office or not.
See, when you move data to the cloud, you should first of all understand that there are security and you must have a risk management process, a risk mitigation process in place. Not avoid putting data in the cloud. That is not the solution to the problem. Some people are quite happy with that native level of security because, let's say, you move from 0 to 5. But suppose a large organization, let's say a bank like First Abu Dhabi Bank or Mashreq Bank, they say that, you know, I'm not happy with 5, I want to move from 5 to 8. There are specialized companies that can offer technologies, processes, people that will enable them to move from 5 to 8.
For your business, you need to maybe look at 3 different aspects. Number one is the application, what we call the application layer. That's a very fancy word to say that you need to have a password to access the software that you use. Okay, that's number one. The second one is security on what we call the access point layer. So it's security for your Wi-Fi routers, for example, which is very simply a very smart way of saying you should have a password to access your Wi-Fi, and you should not give that password to anyone.
Yeah,
and then we have the third layer of security, which the big banks use and the really the mission critical companies use, which is security on the connectivity layer.
If you want to, let's say, suddenly move to work from home in a secure manner, and you want to have, let's say, 10 or 20 of your people who are currently using your financial accounting system, you want to use that in a secure manner. See, from a spend point of view, you will end up spending only about somewhere between $50 to $70 per year per person.
But where do things go wrong? Things go wrong when someone gets your password. It's just very simple. Even if you have like the latest technology and, you know, the best security in the world.
The most cost-effective way and the highest in terms of security would be to adopt what is called the SDP, which is software-defined perimeter. So you can implement a SDP solution very quickly. What happens then is that before you access any data that is owned by the organization, which is inside the office, let's say the data center, or it is in the cloud, what the SDP system first does is that it checks your device, make sure that this device is authentic, make sure that the time at which you are making that connection is right. The place from where you are establishing the connection is also okay. So it clears the device. Once the device is cleared, you are then asked to authenticate. You can have a multi-factor authentication immediately implemented. So you get an OTP, let's say, on your mobile. You put in that, you get access. And once you get access, you are now inside an encrypted tunnel. And through that encrypted tunnel, you only go and hit that application that you have authorization to access. You can't go anywhere else. This is a very simple implementation, and I think that world over, VPN will probably get replaced with SDP, and it is very useful for SMEs.
The agile, the adaptable, the faster are the ones who thrive and succeed in the market. And it all, before technology, if you allow me, Harry, it all starts with mindset. You need to be able to adapt. So it's not about having scenarios, it's about having the resources, the mentality, and the technology to allow you to pivot quickly and change your operating model quickly.